Ladies and gentlemen, our distinguished guests, I am Mrs. Emily Kite, headmaster of Bridgeport International Academy. I stand here today in front of you on behalf of BIA's Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, and administration with the great honor and pride to welcome you to this monumental occasion, our 24th annual commencement exercise. On behalf of the entire BIA community, I extend a warm and heartfelt welcome to each and every one of you. Today we gather here to celebrate the remarkable achievements, dedication, and hard work of our graduating students. This day signifies a culmination of years of academic endeavors, personal growth, and countless memories we share with them. As we gather here today, we also would like to recognize our invaluable contributions of our faculty and staff. They have nurtured minds, inspired curiosity, and instilled a passion for knowledge. Their unwavering commitment to growth and development has prepared our seniors to embark on the next chapter of their lives. I would love to also recognize the unwavering support and love from our families and friends. You have been your students' pillar of strength, providing them guidance, encouragement, and a shoulder to lean on. Your belief in them and your sacrifices have played an integral role in shaping the individuals who are graduating tonight. Today, we celebrate not only the academic achievements of our graduating class, but also the unique talents, passions, and aspirations that each one possesses. Our 2023 graduating class is truly extraordinary. We have distinguished scholars, students who have taken multiple college courses, students who have done very well on multiple college entrance exams, students who are recognized for their academic achievement. We have outstanding leaders and people of integrity, students who have led Student Council and the National Honor Society, students who have started clubs and activities, and students who have not only earned the trust and the respect of their peers, but also of their faculty and staff. We have creative minds, we have problem solvers, we have students who are musicians, who are artists, who are actors and athletes. We have students who look at a problem and see beyond it. Our 2023 graduating class is a true representation of the world. We have students graduating today from Vietnam, Japan, Brazil, Tanzania, Ethiopia, Cabo Verde, South Sudan, and all over the United States. Each student brings their unique perspective and worldview, which strengthens BIA as a whole. Tonight is their night. I am excited to celebrate it with all of you. So without further ado, the class of 2023.
Thank you.
pleasure of welcoming up Bishop Franklin Fountain, pastor of the Fountain of Youth Cathedral located here in the city of Bridgeport. Bishop Fountain has been a very long-time friend of BIA. He was actually did this, oh my goodness, 10, 15 years ago, he was the invocator as well. He believes in educational advancement of our children, as well as dedicating his life to living for the sake of others. We are truly honored to have him here today to give the blessing to our graduates and offer our invocation. So please welcome him.
Good evening. If you would join with me as we pray. Heavenly Father, as we celebrate this momentous event, the graduation day of this class, Father, this class of 2023 of Bridgeport International Academy, we humbly ask this evening your blessings upon each one of these graduates in reaching the significant milestone in their lives. We thank you, God, for their loving and supportive parents and dedicated teachers who have worked tirelessly together to enable them to obtain this pinnacle of success. Their diplomas today, God, significantly show forth their achievements, yet this is a stepping stone to the next phase of their lives. We know that there will be challenges for them to face in the future, so we put our trust in you. Thank you, God, for the years you have been so faithful to our students. You have always guided and protected them in every endeavor and every struggle they encountered. You even favored them during the pandemic years and continue strengthening them with your love. We pray now that you will continue to bless them with your healthy, wonderful love. Bless them with your grace and your mercy. Give them healthy bodies and minds. May you empower and equip and make confident to fulfill their dreams and aspirations. God, draw them nearer to you so they can make better choices and the right decision. Ease their anxieties about the future that is to come. May the years ahead, God, for them be promises, bring promise, fulfillment, and victories. May your joy, your love, your peace be constantly with them. Be their steady companion wherever they go. Direct their path even every day and help them to create our best tomorrow. We say once again, thank you, Father, for the promises of a bright future. For you said in Jeremiah 29:11, for you know the plans for us, declare the Lord plans to prosper us and not to harm us, plans to give you hope and a future. And Heavenly Father, all these things today, we ask and we pray in your wonderful and mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen and adieu.
Thank you, Bishop Fountain. Deeply appreciate that. I'm Dr. Frederick Swartz, and I've served as Academic Dean at Bridgeport International Academy since 2011. I have the special honor of presenting this year's commencement speaker. Mr. Gukwan An first arrived at BIA 18 years ago, in 2005, as a student in the senior class. There's no one on the staff here tonight, neither teachers nor administrators, so had a longer history at our academy. Mr. An has seen the progression of BIA almost from its beginning. When he was a student, BIA was still located on the University of Bridgeport campus here. Mr. An witnessed the academy's purchase and movement into our own facility, and he played a vital role in the achievement and renewing of accreditation and its growth to where it's recognized as one of the top-rated high schools in Connecticut. When Mr. An arrived at BIA in 2005, it was his fourth high school in as many years, having spent two in Korean high schools and one in a public school in Seattle. He immediately distinguished himself as an exceptional student, both academically and in terms of character. He took four college courses as a senior, receiving A's in all four. He received a perfect 800 score in the mathematics portion of the SATs. And as he did in the 10th and 11th grades, had all A's in his high school courses. Upon his graduation in the spring of 2006, Mr. An attended Tufts University in the Boston area. That same year, as Mr. An departed to Tufts, a younger brother of his would enter BIA. All four of Mr. An's siblings ended up following the path pioneered by Mr. An and attending BIA, all outstanding students and individuals, and two of whom would end up being valedictorians at our commencement ceremonies. Mr. An graduated from Tufts University with a degree in philosophy and a minor in mathematics. Even before he finished his collegiate studies, Mr. An took a position in patient research at nearby St. Vincent's Hospital and involved himself as well in SAT and academic tutoring. In the fall of 2011, Mr. An returned to Bridgeport International Academy to serve as a mathematics teacher. His contribution to BIA in this role has been exceptional, developing the curriculum we currently use, introducing a new math course, business math, overseeing student placement in mathematics courses at BIA, and assisting students in their selection and navigation of college math courses. Mr. An has always been far more than just a teacher of mathematics. He devoted long hours to mentor students and to provide seniors with college and career guidance. He stayed after school to run an SAT prep class to help him take him standardized tests. He stayed after school to run help sessions, oversee clubs, and as advisor to the student council. He participated on teams for our accrediting body, NEASC, to assess other high schools in the New England area. At some BIA programs, he led unforgettable and impossible to duplicate team building and game activities. And a year ago, he composed a song on his guitar, dedicated to each graduate, and sang the song for the graduates. He has been beloved for the care he has exhibited for all his students, enthusiastically and tirelessly assisting them. At parent-teacher meetings, he was renowned for staying well above the time allotted for the meetings. One night, I ushered him out of the building, long after the parent-teacher meeting had concluded, concerned that he still had to teach the next morning, only to find him still meeting with the parents on the sidewalk. Most mornings when I opened up the school, I would find him already working in his classroom, and sometimes discovered he'd come back at 10 p.m. or 11 p.m. to work on his lessons for the next day. Special thanks go out to his wife and his family for their patience with Mr. An's dedication to BIA. He actually met his wife while a BIA staff member, and their third child was born just a week ago last Sunday, at St. Vincent's. Mr. An will be starting a new chapter of his life. His dedication helped raise BIA to new heights. He will be greatly missed. I'm sure he will miss BIA. We're delighted we can hear from Mr. An one more time as our 2023 commencement speaker. Mr. An.
Thank you so much, Dr. Schwartz. Make no mistake, this day is for you, for sure. If I could just have a moment for... What to say? I see former students here. I'm a little nervous because I didn't actually expect my family to be here, but my wife is here. And I'm going to talk about my wife, so I don't know what she's going to think about this. First, I'd like to thank the headmaster, Mrs. Keith, and the administrative faculty. Oftentimes, I say this, they're caved in inside their offices, so they don't often see the light of day, and so they rarely see the beaming smiles of our students. Likewise, I know that you as parents caved in your parental duties and professional duties don't sometimes get to see the beaming smiles that we teachers are fortunate enough to see. I hope to share some of that with you today through this graduation process. I've shadowed many schools, and I can say with certainty that I was very moved by the goodness of the people here, for sure. I learned what it meant to work hard, work with a purpose, and I want to always be eternally thankful. Even though it seemed like I was serving BIA for 12 years, really I learned quite a lot in those 12 years in my personal growth. I do want to make a special mention to our previous headmasters, Dr. Frank Labateria and Dr. and Mrs. Spurgeon. They played a huge part in the growth of our school, and I think even though from afar, they are cheering you on and applauding you from wherever they are. I realized very heavily the honor of speaking here today. I was just very lucky that I'm able to be up here. I know all of you have an eternity of words you want to say right now to your children, or to the students, and I'm sorry I'm going to be representing all of you here on the stage. But I do have to apologize as a preface to my speech. For the parents who know, I have two faults. I talk too much, and I have a very monotone voice. These are two very, very terrible traits when it comes to being a teacher and a husband. So I want to thank my students as well as my wife, and to help with this process, I did prepare a PowerPoint so that you don't have to look at this face the whole time. You can look over there. All right, with that in mind, Mr. Shin, can we have the screen up? Oh, we're good? Okay. When I thought about what to say here today, I did want to come here as a teacher, but more I wanted to come as an alum. I was here 1 year. I fell in love with the school. My family fell in love with the school. So hopefully you'll see this as a message from a fellow alum rather than a teacher. I just want to do two things. I know it might take a while to get to those two things. But the first is a very straightforward and short point. As with all straightforward and short points, we need constant reminders of those truths. And so I'd like to start off with an assignment, if that's okay. The assignment is quite simple. I hope that you will use this time to be in the moment, be acutely aware of what you're feeling, take it all in, breathe it all in. Perhaps during this speech you'll reminisce about the last 4 years, think of your loved ones, or hopefully you'll find reflection in my words or in the words of our valedictorian and salutatorian who will come up later. Man, this is hard. okay. Oh, sorry. Yeah, so please, if you could take the moment in. In Korea, we have a very special tradition in education. My mother is also a math teacher. When students don't really want to do work that day, they say, Ms. Sean, let's not study today. Can you talk about your first love? And today, I usually don't share personal details of my life. I'm really afraid of getting too close to my students. But now I can say, since I'm leaving, I'm not 56. I do have children. And yes, I do have a sister that you saw earlier. I want to talk very briefly about my love story. It has a purpose, I promise. I met my wife many years ago. By the way, she's all here again. I was in Korea, and 10 days before I had to leave Korea, my mother says, your aunt thought that this person would be nice for you. Would you like to meet her? And I said, there are only 10 days left. How often can I see her? So I first went and met my wife and then chased after her for 5 days after that. It was quite a ride because with public transportation, it took 3-4 hours each way. And as you can imagine, she felt, I mean, when's this guy going? Meeting her five times, she was working, I was not. So I fell in love. I asked her to come over one winter. She was working as an office staff during that time. We were in Boston. We were in a park. I got down on my knee, took a white clover. Oops. A little bit of air. How do I go back? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, thank you. I took a white clover, made it into a ring, proposed to her on my father's birthday, and we've been together ever since. Yeah, very quick. And then we had children who are the love of my life. We had our son, our third son, May 21st, so not so long ago. And I did cry, but the only reason why I mention this is I didn't really cry because of me. She was solely focused on the baby for 9 months. So for those of you who know, 40 weeks. And when the baby was born, I was only looking at my wife. She had no ounce of ill will toward the baby. Why did you make me suffer? It was just purely the baby was seeking out and crying for the mother, and she, with her emotions kind of choking her voice, just cried out for the baby, and then the baby made his way to the breast, and that's how the baby met his mother. And the baby is very loved. And I think for those of you who met my children, you see that they are very loved. Okay, now let's bring it back to the point I'm trying to make here. All right, I'm sorry that took so long. I'd like to take one hypothetical here. So we have 21 students here today graduating. If you could imagine one seat, one additional seat, right next to Wes, right next to Nico, and there's a student who's going to be graduating with you. There's what's called a death cafe. It's where people go and experience their own death through a timed event. And they write their own will, they write their own eulogy. They get to sit in the coffin. Mr. Shin, sorry. Am I supposed to point somewhere else? Oh. They sit in their own coffin. And a common theme of this are two things I'd like to note. The demographic that this is most popular with is actually people in their 20s who you will be after graduation. And a common theme in their eulogy are messages for themselves. They would say, "You did well. You're all right. You're doing okay. I love you. You deserve to be happy." So these are sincere messages that were common among people who were writing through this experience. And I'd like to direct that back to you. Today, just in the last hour, I saw all of you, you know, helping tidy up each other's clothing, looking at each other saying, "Hey, congratulations, I love you, you'll do fine, I believe in you." And in no instance did you feel you were lying. All of that was sincere. I would just like to ask that you sometimes direct the exact same message with the exact same sincerity to yourself and say that to yourself that you also are doing fine. You also deserve to be very happy. On a lighter note, I'm going to go on a slight tangent. pre-calculus students, I know this brings up trauma of the last few weeks. I'm often asked, "Mr. An, why do we learn this in math? I mean, what is the purpose?" Some of you are doing way too openly there. No one really took me on the offer of me helping explain that if they came after school. So no one really came after school for me to explain. So I'd like to shorten that answer and present it to you. You don't need this for your life. In fact, you don't even need to graduate high school to be. In fact, you don't even need to be here, and I'm quite certain you'll be happy. But you want to be here. You want that high school diploma, and I'd like for you to reflect on why, because you know the difference between two things. Things that add to the quality of your life and things that define the quality of your life. And I think the things that we are fearing, and especially in academia, where we are prone to define our identity by our grades, by our major, by our internship, those things are just adding to the quality of your life. They should never define your quality of life. On that, second hypothetical, and this is my second point. That first point was pretty quick, right? I'm on schedule. Okay. The second hypothetical is if you could imagine two brothers. Every Thanksgiving, they get together and they make a vow to each other. "We are going to be brave men. You and I, we are going to be brave men. That's who we are. That's who we will be." And so every Thanksgiving, they've met and said, "Hey, how's it going? We're brave, right?" "Yeah, we're brave." But at some point, the words felt empty when they said it themselves. And so the older brother couldn't take it, and he went to the city and became a firefighter. And he, in his first assignment, broke down. He really couldn't go into that building on fire. And so he quit. He quit being a firefighter, and he came back. And the next Thanksgiving, they asked each other, "Hey, we're brave, right?" The older brother said, "Not yet." In that situation, who would we rather be? The older brother, who went to go into the city and tried to be a firefighter? Or the younger brother, who never actually sought out an opportunity to be brave? In the end, they both became teachers, and they both tried to be brave in their own respect. But the older brother, there was some depth to the bravery that he showed in his profession in teaching. Now, the reason why I bring up this hypothetical is because for us, we can be happy. It is really within our power. But what's not within our power is opportunity. When opportunity comes to us, we can't make it come back to us whenever we want it to. So we have to grab it when it's there. And I'm going to talk about my wife one more time. The first time I told the love story, it seemed way too Disney-like, and that's not what a married life looks like for sure. This looks like a nice picture to you, but trust me, when she's not happy with me and she sees that face, she wants to rip up that paper. I've certainly caused severe heartache, very deep heartache in my wife. But every time I made that mistake, she would say, "We need to talk." And for all the husbands out there, you know that means the hair on your back of your neck just prickles up, and you know something's going to go down. Now, the easy route, and I've taken this before, is to just be like, "I'm angry, okay? I'm frustrated, so I'm going to just walk out here, okay? You wait until I'm okay to talk." That does not go well, ever. And the reason why I mention this is, just like the two brothers, when I met my wife and I married my wife, I had a goal, and that was to be, I wanted to prove to myself that I was a loving person. And I can say that I'm a loving person, just like the two brothers, every Thanksgiving, you know, every Sunday, I can tell myself I'm a loving person. But if I don't seize the opportunity to really prove to myself I'm a loving person, I don't know if I'll ever believe myself when I tell myself I'm a loving person. So I did, as with all good husbands here, sit down and go through that painful talk where it's always my mistake. But yes, it indeed is my mistake. And now when I say, you know, offhanded comments like, "I'm enamored with you, I love you," now there's more depth to it, and at least she has less hesitation when I say those words now. And it was worth it. I was able to achieve hopes that I didn't even know I hoped. I was able to see that the hopes I had beforehand paled in comparison to what I was eventually able to Yes, you deserve absolutely to be happy, but opportunity doesn't come when you want it to. Please seize that opportunity. I already know you're a good practitioner of this, and I'd like to borrow the words of Paul Bourget, a French poet. Shout out to Stuart, who's studying French on his own. Thank you, Monsieur. Merci, Monsieur. And the quote goes like this. I'll read only the English. I'm going to butcher the French. I already tried with Stuart. "One must live the way one thinks, or end up thinking the way one has lived." For those of you, actually there are only a few of you, who've seen our valedictorian James, sorry to put pressure on you, James, you couldn't imagine that he would be on the stage giving a speech for student council, let alone giving a speech today. Even now, I know just me mentioning this is making him go crazy, but I'm going to do it. Because he's proof that he's a practitioner of this. He practices it, and so he can say he lived the life that he thinks he's lived. And I have many examples here, but I'm looking at time going over. So for those of you who said, I would mention you, I'm sorry, I'm going to skip that for a moment. I'm going to skip that forever, actually. Sorry about that. if there's one American idiom which I'm always confused by, it's the phrase, "break a leg." Because it means ill will to people, but ill will so that you do good. I never really quite understood that, but I think I do, because I'm going to say this. I wish you stress in the next 4 years. I wish you loneliness. I wish you struggles. I wish that so that when you have an opportunity and you seize it, you'll see that your happiness and your self-fulfillment is not defined simply by those struggles. It's defined by something a lot more than that. And so it becomes so insignificant. It pales in comparison to what really defines your happiness and self-fulfillment. As an alum, I've lived some years. I'm 36, by the way. I already know some of you already knew this. Yeah, I'm confirming what you knew all along. But I've lived many years, more than you. If you can just see how much you grew in the last 4 years, how much you've changed in terms of reflecting on you, how much your opinion has changed of yourself in the last 4 years, hopefully you can then trust me when I say, since I've lived quite many more years than you, that this comes from a place of experience. Actually, the Korean word for teacher is actually 선생. It means, it comes from the Chinese character 선, it means early, and 생, birth. Anyone who's born earlier than you has something to teach us. There's something about life experience that we can gain something from. And so from that, I'd like to reassure you, if at any point in your next 4 years you feel like you don't deserve to be there, or really, I don't think I should pursue my goals, how dare you? How dare you be so arrogant to think that you know more than the admissions office, with their years of data and procedures, and then think, I don't actually deserve to be there, when a whole group of people said, yes, you absolutely deserve to be there. So hopefully you won't ever find yourself thinking you don't deserve to be anywhere. And it's already 7:40. Like with all good teachers, I'm going to cram material at the end. I kid. I would like to say the following phrases one last time with hopefully more meaning. You are your best teacher. If you're ever going to think, Mr. An, should we not, should I not, the answer is already no. And I think you can finish this sentence off for me, but I... Never mind, maybe I haven't done my due justice. I believe in you. I believe in you. I hope you believe in you too. I'm very thankful to all of you here. Yeah, I'll end it there. Thank you very much.
Wow. Thank you so much, Mr. An, taking it in. So, hello. Good evening, everybody. My name is Ms. L. I'm the science and language teacher at BIA. Yeah, I'm kind of floored by Mr. An's beautiful commencement address, and let's remember our assignment that he gave us. We already finished school, but we have assignments. There we go. But yes, it's my beautiful honor and privilege to introduce a really wonderful presentation that your classmates have made for you. They go by the name of Sammy Codison. Okay, that's for Samira, Nico, and Edison. So they worked really hard to make this video. It's really fun. There's a lot of moments from your 4 years, if you've been here all 4 years. And if you haven't, then there, you'll still be in the video. So hopefully you can sit back, enjoy the video, soak up those tears with some tissues, all right? And let's enjoy the video. Thank you. Thank you.
I just want to thank Jalen and Enzo because they are really funny and they help me with all of my troubles here mostly. And, you know, they're really good companions, like friends type of, to help me, you know. I just want to say goodbye to them and very well farewell.
Okay. Wait, what about Becker?
Oh, yes, Becker. Becker, he was a really good friend to me, and I actually liked him a lot. He was very energetic sometimes, but yes, I want to thank him too for being a good friend and for being nice to me for the whole year.
I just want to give a big thank you to the seniors, you know, for making my freshman experience a good one. They really helped me feel welcome and really interactive with me, you know. And I just want to give a big thank you to Enzo. You know, like, you're really a great guy, you know. You said hi to me on the first day when I didn't know anybody. And like, you're great. I'll miss you and everybody else too. Thank you.
Hello! I wish you guys the best. You guys have been very great this year. And I do want to say that all of you individually, even though I haven't talked to really, not everyone, but I have seen everyone constantly every day. And I would say that you all seniors are very special people. And you all have a great future ahead of you. So I just want to wish you all the best. And I want to thank you for allowing me to socialize with other people because it was very hard and it was hard for everyone, but you guys really did help everyone and you stood out. It's going to be a quiet next school year in the beginning without you guys. Thank you!
Okay. Hello to all the seniors, and I'm gonna miss you guys a lot. Like, for James, I'm gonna miss all the memories of us in the dorm, the bad memories and the good memories, though. And I'm gonna miss, like, Becca, Yusto, and Daniel. You guys are, like, my first local friend when I come to the US, and I'm gonna miss everyone in the dorm, and the senior in the dorm, like, Yui. I'm gonna miss the day that we go work out together, and that's it.
Yeah! The seniors this year were some of the best people I've ever met. Talking to them helped me learn a lot about the school and about who they are as people. And I'm very thankful for all of them for always being there for me and for everyone else, especially Enzo.
No, because I'm not gonna go with them for the whole life. In one turn, not the whole life.
Okay.
Before you for the whole life.
Kind of specific.
Like if you're just talking about like a group of friends. Like a friend group, I think it's
better. He's not in a friend group. Okay. Enzo, I'm gonna miss you, but I still have a good time in Portugal.
Have fun in Texas. Everybody's going to Texas.
Real. All the Vietnamese kids are going to Texas.
That's so real.
Have fun Vietnamese. Yeah. Now they're going to talk to y'all in Texas.
That's what we said, y'all, because y'all are going to Texas.
Yeah. For real. I'm wearing like big cowboy boots.
A big
cowboy. Right, and I want the horse too.
We should dress as cowboys for Halloween.
We should.
Ashley,
are you okay?
She's a crazy fake crier. Come on, get up. I'm not crying. So I can't
even
cry.
What are you
doing? I need to turn up her back.
Hey guys, you guys graduated. I am so proud of each and every single one of you. Each and every single one of you have made such this year such a great one ever since I came here. And I'm really happy that I have met every single one of you guys. You guys have made me feel so welcomed and everything. And I really am thankful for everything that you've done for us. I'm so proud of you guys. You guys graduated.
I've known half of you since my freshman year, and let me say, every single one of you is hilarious,
especially the new people here. Y'all have made my high school life the best high school life ever, the one that I could never dream that I could have. I am proud of each and every single one of you, and I'm so glad that you're going on with your new life, doing anything that you want to do. Even I love all of you.
Even though, oh my God, that's what's going on. Even though we've only known each other for a year, for me, I'm so grateful for all the memories that we have made together. Going to captains and everything, whatever we have made, playing gym together. I just really want to say I'm proud of each and every single one of you guys. And thank you guys so much for making this, my junior year, the best year ever.
Love you. Mwah.
Say you love your class.
Go seniors.
It was Eli Wiesel who said, "Literature is the beating heart of the world. To take the feelings and emotions, the experiences of all lives and bring them and share them together." My name is Mr. Swartz, and I have the unenviable task of teaching so many people from so many different parts of the world about the world. But this is not about me. This conversation, this speech, it was never about me. It's about you, the students, who day after day read, learned, and strived. One student that I've known for their entire time here, and I saw this student go from being the small little brother to everyone in the entire school, all the way to a leader and the big brother to everyone in the entire school. And so I would like to formally introduce your 2023 valedictorian for Bridgeport International Academy, Hoi Dang!
Hoi Dang, and I'm the valedictorian of Bridgeport International Academy of the year 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, faculty members, proud parents, and the remarkable graduating class of 2023. I want to say thank you to everyone who is here tonight celebrating this very special moment with us. And honestly speaking, I was about to burst down in tears like a few minutes ago when I saw the speech that Ms. Arn made, but thanks to you guys, Nico, Edison, and Samira. You guys cheer me up. Thanks a lot. I think I'll save the tears and the emotions part later. But yeah. Okay, so first and foremost, I would like to express our gratitude to the teachers, the administrators, and the staff members who have guided us through our time here. Your dedication, knowledge, and endless support have been instrumental in shaping us into the individuals we are today. To our parents and families, we owe you guys an immeasurable debt of gratitude. Your love, sacrifice, and faith in us has been the foundation upon which our success has been. Your unwavering support, encouragement, and understanding has fueled our ambition and given us the strength to overcome the challenge. Today, as we stand on this stage, we proudly share this moment with you, knowing that it is as much a celebration of your guidance and love as it is of our accomplishment. My fellow seniors, I just want to say that I love you guys a lot, and I want to say my sincerest thanks to you guys for the incredible 4 years I had here at BA. all the memories, all the dramas, and all the time we spent together, we always hold a very special place in my heart, to be honest. And from the time that we first met as freshmen, up until now, when we are standing here, waiting to graduate, every single moment, every single second and minutes, we always hold a very special place in my heart. Those moments were very precious. And the last thing that I want to say is, thanks to VA being like a small school, thanks to it being small, we have the privilege of individual attention, a nurturing environment, and a strong sense of community. We have been able to explore our passions, embrace our talents, and develop our unique values. This close-knit community has taught us the value of collaboration, empathy, and the strength that comes from supporting one another. Let us carry these values with us as we venture into the wider world, embracing diversity and making a positive impact wherever our path may lead. As we conclude this chapter of our lives, let us express our deepest gratitude to all those who have played a part in our journey. Let us remember the lessons that we have learned, the friendships that we have made, and the memories that we hold dear. Let us go forth with courage, resilience, and an unwavering belief in ourselves, knowing that we have been equipped with the tools to make a difference in the world. Congratulations, class of 2023, and I love y'all, and may your future be filled with success and happiness. Thank you.
Thank you so much for those words, James. Let's give him one more round of applause. So I am Ms. Perkins, and as school counselor and co-advisor for the senior class, it is my honor to now begin the presentation of your diplomas. You made it. So joining me on stage will be our headmaster, Mrs. Emily Keis, and our academic dean, Dr. Swartz. You ready? Okay. Adam Chanil Bodwin. Thomas Rodman Burr. Enzo Coheya. James Dang. Garcia. Yoshito Kai. Thank you. Lay. Matok, Wieu, Deng, Majok. Stuart Matapu. Becker Mohammed. Wesley Michelle Montero Posa. Yuen Lam Nhu Yi. Jalen Ruby Padilla. Samuel Saperstein. Daniel Sohn. Ebenezer Tirfu Faesa. Emmanuel Faesa Tirfu. Wong Ban. Yui Ha Bo. Congratulations, class of 2023. So proud of you.
Welcome tonight. Hello, my name is Lily Shapiro. I'm the Director of Admissions at BIA. It's wonderful to see you all tonight. Let's please join me in another round of applause for the class of 2023. And now I'm going to ask you to join me in another warm welcome for our musical performance tonight. It is my pleasure to introduce you to Enzo and Michelle. Today they will be performing for you a song called Time of Our Lives by Tyrone Wells. I do know that there is some emotions coming to the surface, so please bear with them as they get themselves prepared. But they really wanted to give this song to all of you guys, all of you seniors. And so I know that we're all kind of going back to Mr. On's speech, but take in the moment, take in the assignment, and know that they're really giving this as their gift to you.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Before we move forward with our program this evening, let's give Enzo and Michelle a round of applause. That was wonderful. We will now begin our candle lighting ceremony. The candle lighting ceremony is a special tradition that was established by a first graduating class. It is to have the graduates make a pledge to live their lives for the sake of other people. The pledge will be projected on the slide. The light from the candle symbolizes the light that shines from within and goes forth to others. Our salutatorian, Daniel Sohn, will lead the graduates in making this pledge. Let us welcome Daniel Sohn.
Please join me in the Light of the World pledge. As the 24th graduating class of Bridgeport International Academy, we pledge to live for the sake of others. Let the flame that is ignited here represent the light, which we will forever carry in our hearts. Let this light symbolize our desire to live lives of love and service.
All right, that was beautiful, seniors. Let's give them another warm round of applause, everyone. All right, seniors, you can now blow out your candle, okay? All right, so just to introduce myself real quick. My name is Mr. Kingsley. I run the drama program here at BIA, and I also assist with our college careers program and our online learning program here at the school, okay? At this point, we would like to welcome up representatives Nico and Samira of the BIA student body. They're gonna come to this stage to present to this year's graduating class.
All right, just take a moment to breathe that in, seniors. All right, can we get one more round of applause? That is just beautiful, man. It is my absolute pleasure to introduce our valedictorian, James, and our salutatorian, Daniel, who are going to do the honorary cake cutting.
Okay, let's give them another round of applause. Thank you, Mr. Kingsley. Seniors, I hope you can celebrate and enjoy tonight with your families and friends. I would like to take a moment to thank all the people that made tonight possible. Reverend Fountain, thank you for your beautiful blessing to our senior class. Nico and Samira and Edison, thank you for your amazing video. Enzo and Michelle, thank you for your beautiful song. That was beautiful. Mr. On, where is Mr. On? Is he over there? Where did he go? Okay, Mr. On, wherever you are, I want to thank you not only for your speech tonight, but your years of service to BIA and the time you've offered to the school. It will be forever remembered, so we really appreciate that. I want to thank the entire faculty, student volunteers, graduates, parents, everyone that was able to make this ceremony a success, the University of Bridgeport staff, who also made it possible for us to be here tonight, and of course, to Mr. Shin, who works tirelessly behind the scenes. Makes it all magically just work. Graduates, as you leave the familiarity of BIA behind you, remember to carry the lessons you've learned, the friendships you have formed, and the memories that you will cherish. You have the power to shape the world and make a difference. Embrace challenges that lie ahead, remain resilient in the face of adversity, and pursue your dreams with an unwavering determination. Remember that greatness resides in every single one of you. Graduates, it is now time. You may move your tassels from right to left. Graduates, are you ready to face the world?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2023!
Thank you.